Hey Star Wars fans and collectors, this is a review of the Star Wars Helmet Collection. Now this is an older collection by D'Agostini. You've maybe heard of me talk about them before if you follow me on Twitter. A company who does a lot of Star Wars stuff. They did a near goddamn life-size Millennium Falcon. And you paid about several $1,000 and you would collect the entire pieces to build this Falcon. They've done other stuff in the past. They've done Star Wars Fact Files. You've maybe seen them for Star Trek Fact Files back in the day. They do a ton of stuff. It's all these kind of things. The first free offer you get, you there's a kind of one in here, I think there's a mention of it. One of the issues, the first one is Darth Vader. You sign up for that, it's pretty cheap, it's a low cost. Then the next one you get a little bit more discounted, which is this one, Boba Fett. And then as it goes on, there's other issues and you get freebies and all sorts of stuff. Now this is Australian pricing here, but you can see some of the goodies that you get if you subscribe. T-shirts, a USB drive, binders and folders, and it goes on and on. And I think there's somewhere in the region of a planned 60 helmets, so there's a lot to be had. There's a little display for the helmets going on there. You can eventually create all these things. So I'll show you some of these helmets in a second. I'll put a link underneath where you can pick this up. This has been out in Europe for a little while. They're up to about issue 30 so far. And generally that's how D'Agostini works, is they'll launch it in Europe, they're an Italian company. And if it works there for them, then they'll generally launch it in Australia. Never really comes to the US as far as I know. If you are in the US and that you actually get D'Agostini there, then please let me know. But I don't think they do. I don't know what it is, some kind of licensing issue or something, I don't know. But you guys in the States, for the few years that I stayed there, you never really get the kind of great magazines and comic books in some ways that the UK gets in Australia. We're such suckers in the UK and Australia for lots of magazines with free offers and little toys on the front cover. There's just tons of them, but I think shipping wise in the States it just doesn't seem to work. I don't know, but in the Australia and the UK, this is the back of it. You can see this is the kind of stuff that you get. So it's a really huge ass big kind of fold out here. So literally every issue you get a fact file and a helmet and a little case. There's Luke there, and they are pretty damn good. They're really not bad. Sometimes you get really shoddy looking ones, the Stormtrooper helmet. Not bad. That's not bad. That's pretty good. And each fact file comes with stuff you've seen before, really from kind of those huge DK encyclopedia books, pretty much kind of reprinted or repurposed in some ways. But those little helmets look pretty good, and I think given Hasbro's fairly lackluster response to the helmet regular kind of collection out there, the Black Series collection, it's just not doing too well. I don't know whether we're going to get many more, so if you really want to collect these helmets, then this is definitely the way to do it. If you want a real display collection of these helmets, then I would recommend this is the one to get. So lots of fold out stuff as well, little explosions and details and lots of stills from the movie, really. It's relatively tame stuff, but if you're not a complete super geek nerd on Star Wars like me, then you might like this. Bounty Hunters, always fun, a little bit of fan art and other stuff in there. So it's relatively interesting, it's pretty good stuff to see. But it's kind of like, as I said, that DK encyclopedia stuff, really. And most people I know tend to buy these magazines just for the helmets they want. But a pretty impressive collection that would make. And talking of, there it is. So underneath you'll see there's a little clip on either side. So if I kind of unclip that, if I pinch, I should... It does come off, I've had it. Before. Come on. We'll do it live. We'll never come off. Come on. There we go. Nearly broke that. Right, there we go. So each helmet comes on this little plinth stand. It's got the name marked on the front there. And it's actually not bad. It's got a nice kind of silver finish to it. A wash on it. Could do with a little more weathering, really, but it's really not bad. It's pretty intricate details. Nicely done transfers. It's got all the right little greeblies pretty much in the right place. That's flat instead of a little metallic piece it should be. But that's not bad. This does not move forward, so don't. But it's pretty nice. Got the dent. So, look, it's not bad. It's a little off in terms of symmetry, I think. But for something like $10, it's not bad. It's pretty good, I think, considering Hasbro charges about $10 or $12 for the two helmets. And you get all this extra stuff with it, so... That's it. There's a ton of these, as I said. There's 30 already been released, and you'll find a lot of them are available on ebay.co.uk, because that's or probably Ireland as well. They're pretty slick little helmets. I do like them, so I'll be looking out for Cody and a few others here and there along the line if I can find them. But Biker Scout looks pretty good, and a few others. So yeah, some nice little helmets from this. But let us know what you think. If you've collected D'Agostini before, or you're in the States and you're just livid you can't get this, I don't know. Leave a note. Let us know. We shall see you for more reviews and other stuff. And we'll be back then. Bye.